Hi guys, it's Sam, and I am going to be doing a video that has been requested on my channel. It is from the video. I got a lot of comments on the video, Day in the Life of Paraprofessional / Teaching Assistant in New York City. And a lot of the comments were asking how to become one, what are the requirements, and I thought I would try to answer some of that in this video. And I want to just put a disclaimer right now, and I could only obviously speak from my experience being a para, as we like to call ourselves, in the New York City school system. Each state is different. Maybe each city is different. I'm sure there's some overlapping things, but I just want you to keep that in mind that I am only going to talk about New York City paraprofessionals. And I thought I would just briefly talk about this. So this is, you can find on the DOE website. I'll put the link below. I even put it, I think, in the original video. And I remember that helping me so much when I was trying to see what the requirements were. They list step by step what you need to do. And that could have been my video where I just read this verbatim and that would have been it. But I kind of want to tell you from my experience and just give you some hints and tips and things like that. And I've been putting off this video for so long. I've been saying I'm gonna do it, and I felt like my makeup was bad, or I was tired, or I was wearing the wrong outfit. Surprise, I'm wearing a hoodie and my hair is up, and I know I'm not gonna get everything that I want to tell you out there. So if I miss something or if you need more information, just, you know, direct message me or write a comment below. And I thought I would start off telling you a little bit about, like, a background story about me and how I got to become a para and what led me to this job. And so I have been a para for 5 years. This is my fifth year. I started, I believe, in, I feel like 2015, 2016. Yeah, I think that makes it, that math adds up, right? And I started off in second grade, and then I was asked to go to pre-K, and I wanted a job, so I said, yes, of course I'll go, and I've been doing that ever since. And I absolutely love it. And I, you know, people always ask, why don't you become a teacher? And I mean, the pay obviously is much better as a teacher, but I really feel like this is a right fit for me, and I'm very, very happy. So my background, I was very lost after high school. Like, when I got to college, I just didn't know what to do. And after I graduated with some, I was gonna say stupid degree, but it was just a useless degree. I wanted to get out of college right away. I probably should have dropped out in hindsight, but I just stuck with it and graduated. I got a job in an office because of a neighbor. She had a job, and I worked there for a long time, about 6 or 7 years. I didn't have any bills or insurance or anything like that to worry about, so I was just like, oh, this is great. I'm earning money, and I was spending money. And then I just grew to hate it, and I was like, what am I going to do? I don't want to work in this specific place for the rest of my life. I don't mind working in an office, but that particular office was just bad for me and just caused a lot of stress. So I decided to go to nursing school, or LPN school, practical nursing, and I graduated from there, and I lasted 2 weeks. I hated it. It was a terrible lesson to learn, but now I know that I would not go back to nursing. And after that, I was just at home, not doing anything with my life. And my mom, who happened to be a principal, was like, why don't you come to my school? She was actually retiring, and somebody else was principal. And she was like, why don't you go to the school, follow a para, and see if you would like to, maybe that's what you would like to do. And I did it, and I haven't looked back. I started working on the paperwork right away, and I got hired. So, I mean, that's obviously the Cliff Notes version. Do people still read Cliff Notes? I remember that was big in high school. And Yeah, so my mom, she was a Catholic school teacher, then she was a public school teacher, then she moved up to assistant principal, and then she became principal. So this is the part where it's very important. There's a few things that need to happen before you can even become a paraprofessional. Like, you can't just go into a school and say, "Hey, I would like to be a para, please hire me." The first thing you have to become, is this is gonna sound so funny, is a substitute paraprofessional. Like, you can't just become a paraprofessional, which I don't understand why, but you have to become a substitute paraprofessional. And I was lucky enough to have the connection through my mom and get into that school. The other thing that needs to happen, so you have to become a sub para first before you become a para. Two other very important things are, one, you need to have a principal nominate you, and nominations have to be open. So nominations are simply the principal kind of vouches for you, and then you are put into like a computer system. The reason I'm doing this video today is because I just checked, and it's been like this for about a week now, maybe even longer. I don't know if you can see that. Right here, it says substitute paraprofessional nominations are now open. Now, there's a few ways you can go about getting nominated. Again, I have been very fortunate that I knew a principal. You can go to schools. Maybe you're interested in a specific school and ask them to nominate you, or if you know a friend, like I have a friend of a friend, or you have a connection there, you can do it that way. And so there's just so many things that have to be working for you. One, the nominations have to be open, which they are currently, so this is the right time to do it if you have been thinking about it. And a principal has to nominate you. And I know I wanted to touch on, I didn't have to go to principal or school to school to ask them to nominate me. So I can't tell you that much about it, but I know of others that have done that. So it is something that you can do. And I also wanted to touch on pay. I think that's probably another important thing. You do not make a lot of money doing this. I am okay with the pay. It's good for me. I don't know, like, in the future if I have children, or I might have to get like a part-time job or something else. So I am gonna refer to this because it tells me the exact amount that you get. So you have to start off as a sub para, and you make, as of February 14th, you make $157.87 per day. Now, all of this changes when you become full time. I became full time after 2 years, my friends. It might have been even, I think it was 2.5 years. And that was a long time. At the end of that, I was getting really anxious because I was commuting to work. I didn't have any health benefits, dental, vision, nothing. And I was like, to the principal, I'm like, "Listen, I can't keep on doing this if I don't get hired." And I did get hired in January as full time. So I am now making $42,000, and that's the highest that I'll make. That's after, so I have a college degree, I have some experience, but until our contracts are negotiated, that's it. You, as a full-time, when I first became full-time, I started making about $25,000, and you can look this stuff up. This stuff is readily available. So I got to the highest because of salary upgrades. After working for a few years, my college degree, and this was done. So I did step by step. I did, I think, 9 salary upgrades, but that took a while. It wasn't like right away they gave me the $42,000. You have to keep in mind, though, that I also get a pension. I get a 401k. dental, vision, health insurance, and it's, I just, for me, it's good. For you, I mean, it might be different. You might be looking for more money. And I want to also say that they have a couple of programs where they will pay you to go to school. I think it's called the Leap to Teacher program. And they have a couple of other things that you can do if you are interested in getting inside a school and then becoming a teacher. So that is, if that's like your end goal, you can definitely use this as a stepping stone. I feel like if it was 10 years ago, I would have jumped at the chance to become a teacher, but I'm comfortable, but I'm also very happy at what I'm doing. And so to just go back to this informational page, I don't know what to call this. This is just, it's an informational page about paraprofessionals. I wanted to talk about, so even it's been a long day, my friends. It is currently 7 p.m. I haven't eaten yet. Eligibility requirements. Yay, I got it. In order to apply for a substitute paraprofessional position, you must have at least an online nomination by a school principal, and nominations have to be open. I'll put that in parentheses. A high school diploma or GED, proficiency in reading, writing, and speaking the English language, authorization to work in the U.S. So really, a high school diploma. And so after you get nominated, there's several classes that you have to take. And I would say I spent around, I don't remember how much each class was. You have to take about 4 or 5 classes. And it's on school violence and bloodborne pathogens, things like that. Probably around $300 to $400. And that's including being fingerprinted and photographed by the DOE. You do have to take an exam, but it's called, let me see exactly what it's called so I don't get it wrong. The New York State Assessment of Teaching Assistant Skills. Do not fret about this test. It was fairly simple and straightforward, and you will have no problem. I was so nervous about it that I went to Barnes & Noble's, and there are study guides out there that you can use, but I wouldn't worry about it. It's a very straightforward test. I'm just trying to think of other things to tell you about. And I mean, one thing that keeps on coming to mind is what I do day to day. Now, I know this is going to sound like so simple, and why am I even bothering saying this, but you have to like children somewhat. It's just not going to be fun for you or the children if you don't like working with children. It's just, I can see from experience, people who are like miserable being with the kids, and it's just a terrible. Now, I'm not saying every day I just have the greatest day ever, but I do find the work rewarding and I enjoy going to work, which I know not everyone can say that about their job. I like my coworkers and the community. So overall, it's just, I'm very happy. I want to point out that one of the downsides besides the pay is you do not get to choose what grade you are going to work in. Every year, the school assesses the need, and they will put you where they need you. So you could be watching a kid with a peanut allergy. That's what I did my first year as a sub. They needed somebody to watch a child with a peanut allergy in second grade. And so I was with him a lot, but then they also moved me around to pre-K, third grade. I feel like I went to first grade. And so I got a little bit of experience, but depending on where you get hired, I can work anywhere from pre-K to fifth grade, really, if they wanted to move me around. And so if you choose a high school, you're going to be anywhere from freshman to senior. I have been very, very fortunate in that they have asked me to keep on working in pre-K. And so that's just, I don't know if I could do older grades now that I've been with pre-K for so long. I would do it because I want to keep my job and that's where they need me, but I would like to stay in pre-K for as long as I can. I would prefer the younger grades, but again, I will go anywhere they need me to. Now, I know I didn't answer a lot of the exact questions step by step about how to become para, but I just feel like this going on the website is probably the best thing. I just wanted to give you a little insight into what I think is important to tell you about this, and I hopefully you found some of this relating to what you were looking for those of you that were interested. And again, if you have any questions, I will try my best. It's been 5 years since I have done this, but it doesn't look like much has changed. So definitely write me a comment or direct message me, and I will get back to you. I try to answer everyone's comments on that video. So I know a few of you have started as paras, and that is super exciting. I remember I was very nervous the first time that I went into a classroom, but I have been very lucky that the people I've worked with, the school that I'm at, is just so supportive, and you just need to find the right fit for you and the grades too. So yeah, I hope you enjoy this video, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.